Hello students, how are you all? I just hope that you all are safe at your places. So now students, your second term examination, they will start from 14th of December, and your second term syllabus will be from 15th assignment to 25th assignment, okay? And one more thing, that this time the exam pattern will be subjective type. That means you have to write proper answers, okay? So kindly prepare according to that. Now students, we will continue with the same chapter 4, plant life, okay? And earlier I told you about what is photosynthesis and various steps which takes place during photosynthesis. Now today you're going to learn about stomata, its structure and its working. Okay, so let's start with stomata. Stomata, they are the tiny pores. They are present on the surface of the leaves. Okay, earlier I told you about photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? The process by which green leaves, they prepare their food using sun's energy, carbon dioxide and chlorophyll. Okay, and the exchange of gases, it takes place through stomata, these tiny pores that are present on the surface of the leaves. Okay, so carbon dioxide, it enters through the stomata. Okay, so stomata are the tiny pores present on the surface of the leaves of plants through which carbon dioxide gas enters the leaves of the plant. Now, it also allows the movement of gases in and out of plant cells. Just now I told you that carbon dioxide, it enters the leaves, and oxygen gas, which is produced during the process of photosynthesis, it is also released out in the air through these tiny pores. Okay. So now let's see its structure. This is the structure of stomata. Now stomata, it consists of two guard cells. As you can see here, these are the guard cells and this is the stomatal opening. Okay, now each stomata pores, they are surrounded by these guard cells. Okay, and the opening and closing of stomatal pores is controlled by these guard cells, and the guard cells, they contain a large number of chloroplasts, as you can see here. And what is the function of chloroplasts? Chloroplasts, they trap sun's energy or sunlight. Now comes working of stomata. Now how stomata, it works. Stomata, when water flows into the guard cells, they swell. That means they increase their size and they become curved also. Here you can see the shape of the guard cell. It is curved, and which makes the stomatal opening or the pores to open. Then when the guard cells, they lose water, then what happens? They shrink. That means they decrease their size and they become straight. And when they become straight, then stomatal pore, it closes. Then a large amount of water, it is also lost from the cells of the plant leaves through open stomatal pores. Okay, now when the plant, they does not need carbon dioxide and wants to conserve water, then what they do? The stomatal pores, they are closed. Now the oxygen gas, just now I told you, which is produced during the process of photosynthesis, it also goes out through these pores. Carbon dioxide, it enters through these pores, and the oxygen also, it goes out in the air through these pores. Now the green stem or shoot of the plant, they also carry out photosynthesis. It is because stomata, they are also present in the stems. Now comes factors affecting photosynthesis. Photosynthesis, you already know, is a process by which green plants prepare their own food. Now, there are certain factors that affect the process. Conditions, you already know, which is necessary for the process of photosynthesis are sunlight, chlorophyll, temperature, water, and carbon dioxide. Now, if there will be increase in temperature, then it will also increase the rate of photosynthesis, okay? Now, the optimum temperature for photosynthesis is 20 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius. That means between this temperature, between 20 degree to 40 degree, the process of photosynthesis will be better. Not below 20, not above 40. Okay. Now, not more than 1% of total water absorbed by the plant is used in photosynthesis. Now, as you know that green plants, they absorb water from the soil, okay? And from the total water which is absorbed by the plant, only 1% water is used for the process of photosynthesis, okay? Now, concentration of CO2 beyond a certain level decreases the rate of photosynthesis. Now, CO2 is carbon dioxide. So, if the concentration of CO2 will increase beyond a certain level, then it will affect the photosynthesis. Then the presence of chlorophyll is essential for the process of photosynthesis. Now, chlorophyll, they are the green color pigments. And what they do, they help in trapping sun's energy, okay, sunlight. So, its presence is very important for the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so these are the factors affecting photosynthesis. Now comes significance of photosynthesis. Significance means importance of photosynthesis. Now, how photosynthesis is important for animals, plants, and for human beings. Okay, now first of all, plants, they not only prepare their own food by this process, but what they do, they are providing nourishment, they are providing food for both plants and for animals and for human beings also. Okay, so first point is that it provides food to animals and human beings also. Now, the second one is photosynthesis capture and preserve sunlight. Now, sunlight is preserved by, preserved during the process of photosynthesis. Why? Because green plants, what they do, they capture the sunlight. Okay. Then, the third one is the energy captured by plants are stored in the fossil fuels such as coal, petroleum, natural gas. Coal, petroleum, and natural gas, all these are fossil fuels, okay? And these fuels, they are used for domestic and for industrial use. Then, fourth one, oxygen is released in the air during the process of photosynthesis. So, oxygen, you know what we take in? Animals and human beings, they breathe in oxygen, okay? So, oxygen is very useful for animals and human beings, and it is also useful for plants because they use oxygen for respiration during night, okay? So, these are the importance of photosynthesis.